Alright, so I'm doing a review on this vacuum, the Armorall 12-volt car vacuum. I think the model number is 34-2016. I guess it 2016 represent the year that they started this. This vacuum comes with a bag to store your vacuum. A decent bag. As well as, this is a wet vac. A wet vacuum squeegee tool, which is used just to create a suction between the carpet. It's like a seal suction between the carpet and the vacuum. So this has a little flap that I guess it creates some kind of seal between the floor and the vacuum. And it also comes with a dirt extracting brush, which attaches to the vacuum. Now, the dirt extraction tool only fits on the crevice extension, which I think they should have. Oh, but I think you could push it in. No, you can't push it in. So it goes on this way. The only thing I don't like about this is, being that this is so long, it might reduce the suction rate. But anyways, that I don't know, because we're testing this out for the first time. I just purchased on eBay. I paid $27 for this vacuum, which includes all taxes, shipping, and everything. What I like about this vacuum, it has the HEPA filter inside the vacuum. So if any dust passes through the filter, it'll get caught in this filter right here. The only downside about that is you would have to open up the whole unit in order to clean the filter or bring it in to get it serviced by Armorall. So now let me go inside the vacuum, and this is your actual filter, which pops off like so. It's a generic standard fiber filter, and this is your wet vac filter. This is going to channel the water into the cup opposed to getting sucked into the vacuum. So I'm guessing that this vacuum has some sort of limit line, and let me see if I can find a limit line anywhere. Okay, so this is your max. So after you pass this value, then water is going to be sucked into the vacuum, which is going to damage your vacuum permanently or temporarily. That I don't know, and that I am not willing to test with my new vacuum. Okay, let's give it a try. So I'm just going to run through a couple of tests with this vacuum, if I can figure out how to put this thing on. How do you clip this off? Okay. Alright, so now I'm going to try to vacuum up all of this little debris right here that I pre-planted here for test purposes only. Alright, so the first test I'm going to do is to vacuum the carpet with the car not running. So I'm just going to run the vacuum directly off the 12 volts battery power and see how good is the suction. If it could take this penny up, then this vacuum is definitely a keeper for me, because that's how I test my vacuum, with a penny. If it could suck the penny up, then it could basically suck up anything in the car. So let's go. So it did not suck up the penny. So let me try it to see if we can get that penny up. So I have the wet squeegee installed, and it's clearly telling you that the top, so we know it's installed the right way. So let's see if we can get it with the wet squeegee. And we got it with the wet squeegee. So as I thought and was proven correctly, this is to create like extra suction. So this is a good tool for you not to lose. Now this that you know the purpose of it.
Better suction.
This creates better suction between the carpet and the suction nozzle. So this is a tool you don't want to lose. You want to hold on to it now that you know what's the purpose of it. So it has two functions. It takes up, it extracts water from the carpet, as well as creates a better suction between the carpet and the suction nozzle. So guard this tool with your life. All right, so let's dump out the trash back onto the carpet. And we're going to do another test. This time we're going to test it. With the engine running. So we're going to start the engine now, and we're going to test the vacuum with the engine running. All right. So the engine is running. Previously, the battery was at 12.4 volts. Because this is a brand new car, so it has a brand new battery, so it's going to have a higher voltage. And now the battery is at 14.5 volts. So we're going to start vacuuming up. So I'm going to vacuum without the wet vac suction nozzle. And I was able to suck up the penny very easily
while the car is running. This vacuum works better while the car is running.
Some vacuums cannot work when the car is running for some reason. But this vacuum works marvelously, marvelously when the car is running. Because to pick up a penny is a very hard task for a 12-volt vacuum. Okay. So we're gonna dump that out again. And dump out this. Dump the filter out. Alright, so let me put the filter back in. Let me install the wet vac suction filter. That's incorporated with the whole nozzle piece. Alright, so let me just get that back on. So now I'm going to use my crevice tool. So I'm going to use a crevice tool with the car off to see if I'm able to pick up the penny as well as the dirt that's on the carpet. So was able to pick it up. I mean, it's no sense in doing the rest of the test because it surely passed. I guess I can wrap it up. Why not? Let me just finish the rest of the tests that I was going to do. Just do it real quick. So I'll just complete the full test. So I'm dumping everything back out. And putting in back the filter. Let me just get all this trash back out. Put the filter back in. Install the nozzle piece. Alright, so I'm going to put this on. And this is the brush connection. Now let's see how we do. Overall, this is a pretty decent vacuum. I think my final thoughts about this vacuum, it's pretty decent. On a scale of 1 to 10, I could give it an 8.1. And why an 8.1 is because I believe that this vacuum was designed to clean new cars. New cars with Teflon coating on the carpet. And for you guys who don't know, when cars are manufactured, because everything is covered under warranty for 3 to 4 years, depending on what type of car it is, what type of warranty plan the car comes with. And meaning that if anything goes wrong within the 3 years or at a certain mileage, the dealer would have to replace it, no charge to you. So that's including the carpet of the car. So what they do is they spray a Teflon coating on the carpet of new cars. How do I know this? I was told, but you can actually test this by actually feeling the carpet. And if it doesn't have a natural feel, then it has a Teflon coating on it. If it has like a rough, dry feel, a rough, dry kind of non-sticky feel, like when you say your hands are greasy from sweat, don't actually put grease on your hand because that'll ruin your carpet. Your natural sweat oils, if you rub onto the carpet like this and then you actually still feel the sweat on your hands, that means you have Teflon coating. You have a good amount of Teflon coating on your carpet. After 4 years, then naturally it starts to deteriorate, and that's when all the stains and the spots and the discoloration comes in on the carpet, because now you're out of the warranty period. So a cheaper car like this, it has a light Teflon coating, so this will probably fade out just by normal usage in about 3 years. Higher end cars, the carpet will feel more thick and it will have a more fake feel to it, if you understand that. If, you know, that's a good
this
analogy.
Vacuum is made solely to maintain a new car. Because they figure, well, if a guy buys a new car, he's going to want a new vacuum. So why not give him a new vacuum at a good price point. I mean, $27, but I've seen it as low as $20. So, yeah, I'll rate it an 8.1 for that reason. And for an older car, I would go with the Black & Decker BDH 2200. That vacuum runs about $80 to $100. It's a 20-volt lithium-ion battery. Battery ran device. It runs for anywhere from 16 to 20 minutes on one charge. And that depending on the state of the battery. For $80, I don't think it's worth it. But if you have an older car and you want to maintain it or keep it clean as best as possible, then I would go for the Black & Decker over any plug-in vacuum. But if you have a brand new car, get this. Definitely get this. If you have a brand new car and you just want to maintain your car,
I bought the Black & Decker vacuum and it worked phenomenally. But at the price point, plus the fact that you would have to take it home every night to recharge it and to bring it back into your car to charge it, it was just too overwhelming to me, especially a person like me that's always on the road doing insulation city to city. And I love to have a well-kept car. I just like to have everything neat and organized because I think that makes the business more efficient.
Build quality is pretty decent. I think you could drop it a couple of times and it will to pieces on you. The only drawback with this vacuum is that it has a filter, which you will always have to maintain. So you would have to wash this filter and dry it. That's the only downside. Because if you don't do that, then you're just going to have mold and mildew just blowing out of the, blown through the back of the vacuum. And that's going to have your car smelling horribly. Believe me, I've known. I had an 18-volt Black & Decker BDH. I think, I forgot the model number. It was a Black & Decker 18-volt lithium-ion thing. And I left the, and that was a bagless vacuum. And I left like dirt and debris in there for a couple of months, and that vacuum, I had to throw it out because it was so stink. So having learned that lesson, now I take all my filters out and I wash and dry them. So you can actually I just take this whole thing with me. Take this whole thing home with me, wash it, set it out to dry, and then I'll have it ready for tomorrow.
Ion vacuum and charging it every night. But what if you forget to charge it every night? And then you'll be coming down with a dead vacuum, or you'll be coming down with no vacuum. With this, if I forget, at least I could still use it.
If you check it out,
and still maintain my car. Because if I take this into my house, I forget to clean it, I could still take it out and vacuum my car. Opposed to me taking a 20-volt lithium-ion vacuum into my house, forgetting to charge it, bringing back a dead or not bringing back a vacuum at all to my car. And the main purpose of having a vacuum is to always keep your car clean. So again, this always wins. This trumps out. This is a better solution. So if any of the designers of Armor All is watching this video, you got to do something about
out of
filter.
The filter
and give us some kind of mesh situation, some kind of fine mesh that we could wash and it will dry real quickly. This filter takes a long time to dry. You have to set it overnight and it takes at least maybe 4 hours to dry completely, just on a standstill. So if you guys are watching at Armor All, this filter was a bad idea. This is the only drawback for me, and that's why I gave it an 8.1 out of a 10.
The suction, I think, is pretty adequate for a new car. But the suction could be a little bit better. So out of a suction rating from 1 to 10, I would have to give it an 8.9. Because I believe that you could get more suction. Maybe you could reduce the coil size and therefore get more RPM out of the motor. And that's an effective way, opposed to using the digital motor, which will give you more RPM at more efficiency. But do you really need efficiency when you're running off a car's battery alternator? So again, that's more of a design thing. That's more of a cost thing with the company. But I definitely believe that they could do something better with this filter. So therefore, I give this vacuum an 8.1 out of 10. And that's my review. If you have any comments, hit me up in the comment section. And this is your boy, Precision Connections Auto at PrecisionConnectionsAuto.com. Check out the website. Hit me up on Twitter. Hit me up on Facebook. Hit me up on Instagram. Everything is linked in the description box. Check out my video editor, Michelle Johnson. Check out her channel. And just support the movement 2017 and beyond. PrecisionConnectionsAuto.com.